welcome back. And if you joined us late, The Art of Baking. And my guest is Chef Lynard, who is from the Charlotte, North Carolina area. And we're delighted to have you. Now, those cookies look wonderful.
Thank you. There.
Now, what else did you bring to share?
All right. So what we're going to do now is a bourbon pecan chocolate chip pie.
Okay.
All right.
Now the burner's on here.
So, yes, what we have to do with the simpler way of making, a lot of people tend to find that when you make pecan pies, you either have to bake it too long, and they tend to be syrupy at the end. By doing this method, you're actually cutting down or reducing the bake time of it.
Okay.
We're not going to put it on the eye yet because we have to go ahead and put in some of the ingredients, but what we do have the eye preheating on medium. All right, we're going to go ahead and add in, that's a cup of brown sugar. This time we're using light brown sugar.
Okay, 1 cup.
1 cup.
Okay.
All right. Then we have two-thirds cup of corn syrup, just regular light corn syrup.
So these are ingredients that most people would have.
Would ordinarily have.
Not anything exotic.
Exactly.
Okay.
And this is what you traditionally see in a pecan pie. The only difference is that we're actually pre-cooking some of it to dissolve the sugars. All right. So what we're going to do next, we're just going to go ahead and place this on the eye. And you'll see it start to dissolve that.
You really love to bake, don't you?
I do. It's a passion. And then what we have next is a couple of splashes of vanilla. Not too much, just a couple of dashes of that. That should be enough.
So these really are ingredients that I think most of us might find in our kitchen.
Exactly. And that's why I selected these recipes to make it easy. And then, of course, with the holiday season, a lot of people do tend to buy more of these ingredients or already have them on hand. So we're just going to let this dissolve. Basically, what we're looking for is to dissolve the sugar.
You want all the lumps out of it.
Exactly. It's just going to smooth it out. All right. We're just going to let that go for just a moment. I'm going to go ahead and cut that.
It's on medium. I put it on medium. Is
yes,
that what
ma'am.
You want?
That's perfect. We're going to cut it down just so to get a little simmer going. And then next, we're actually going to go ahead and crack three large eggs. We're just going to set these to the side, however. We can't use them right away. All right. All right, so that's 3 eggs. You got to be careful with eggshells. That's why we always crack it in a separate bowl. Let me wash my hands real quick here.
Now that's getting hot.
Okay.
I don't know if it's hot enough.
No, it's perfect. So
is that all right?
Yes, ma'am. All right, so we're incorporating this. We still want to get any lumps out of here.
Okay.
All right. So what we're going to add that makes this extra special is the bourbon. And we're only going to put 1/4 cup in there.
This gives it a little extra
flavor. Just an extra flavor. And it's not overpowering, overbearing to where you're going to taste the end result.
Okay.
Now what you want to do with any alcohol or liquids is to remove the pan from the stove.
Okay.
And just go ahead and pour it in gently.
That's what, about 1/4 cup?
1/4 cup.
Okay.
All right, and we're doing the test with actually Jim Beam. We found that it has a smoother taste.
Now, you could do it, if you didn't want to put that in there, you could still use the recipe without that.
You can admit that, definitely.
Okay.
All right, so we're going to go ahead and incorporate that. And you can smell it now, but again, once it's actually been baked,
you won't be able to even know it's there.
Exactly.
But it does give it a little extra flavor,
I guess. All right. All right. And I found a good way to incorporate everything is to actually just go ahead and whisk it in.
because you're trying to make that batter smooth. You don't want any lumps in there.
Right. And once all the liquid's in, all the sugar will smooth out eventually anyway. And what we're also going to add as well is just a pinch of salt. If you don't want to do salt, you don't have to have salt.
Okay, and he's got 3 eggs here. So
the eggs are not going to go in yet. If you were to actually put these in at this time, it would actually scramble them.
Oh, we don't want scrambled eggs in there.
So we're going to add a pinch of salt. All right. And now you can actually cut the oven off.
Okay.
I'm sorry, you can cut the stove top off.
Wait, I was going to say, okay, let's see.
It's off. So what we're going to do, what you have to do for this recipe is actually have a little bit of patience on this one. Right now, again, with this liquid being hot, if you were to add the eggs right away, you could scramble.
Yeah.
Exactly.
But you have to wait for that to cool, and then you put 3 eggs in there and beat them up.
Right. What you want to do is to have this liquid cool.
Yeah.
All right. And then you're going to go ahead. An easy way, if you don't have time to wait too long, is what you can do is called tempering. So tempering is just adding a little bit of this liquid into the egg. And what that does is bring it to the temperature to get ready to be incorporated into this. So I'll just add a little bit more. And again, this is an important step if you can wait to let this cool down a little bit, because if you don't, you will have scrambled eggs in this mixture.
Okay, but you know, on television, we have to keep moving.
Exactly. So what you're going to do here is just go ahead and put in 1 egg at a time. You'll whisk those in. You'll go ahead and add in. Once those are fully incorporated, if you want to open these for me, Peggy,
get it open.
Just screw it. Yes, ma'am.
Oh, my heavens.
You got it?
You got that on there to stay. Ooh, look at all those.
So what you're going to do is just go ahead and pour those in.
All of them?
Yes, ma'am. That's actually 2 cups of pecans. All righty.
Oh, that's lovely. Look at that. Yum.
Now, to this mixture, but you do afterwards, which you can admit that as well, if you don't want chocolate chips in it, that's your traditional pecan pie.
You could do that without the chocolate chips
exactly.
If you wanted to.
What we do is go ahead and add in 1/2 cup of chocolate chips to that mixture. We stir
it up. You add those in right now?
Yes, ma'am.
You don't have to let it get cool?
No, because it's going to go ahead and melt a little bit once you bake it. So you add those to the mixture, and then we have a 9-inch pie pan that we actually use. The crust is not homemade. It's something that you can just go to the convenience store.
That was my next question.
Yes.
You can go and buy the ready-made crust.
Exactly.
And I mean, you know, unless you tell people, they're not going to know.
Right.
They'll
That's going to save
you
some time.
Right.
So once we have that all incorporated, we actually pour that into the pie shell. We put it on a jelly roll pan, and then we pop it in the oven.
All right. Now, you don't grease that pan at all?
No, man, because the pie...
You just put the pie right on the pan
right.
to bake it.
Now, the thing about the pie crust, you want it to actually be frozen, and you don't want to pre-bake it, because pre-baking it is going to cause it to brown a little bit too much.
Oh, so you want to have a frozen pie crust.
Yes.
And then you do all of this and put it in the pie... You don't wait for the pie crust to thaw?
No. You go ahead and just pour
it
in.
Put it in the frozen pie crust.
Yes, ma'am.
And then put it in the oven and bake it for how long?
You put it in a 375-degree oven, and you bake it for 60 to 70 minutes, depending on how hot your oven gets.
Yeah, you kind of have to watch, because every oven is different.
Exactly. I found that a good range is 65 minutes.
Okay. And, of course, we have a pie down there that is absolutely beautiful. And this, you know, this would go into any dinner,
right.
any time of the year. But especially, I think, from now on, when people are thinking of sharing with loved ones, and you want something special.
Exactly.
You know. And then you brought along with that, we have here on the tray, of course, the cookies. And that's a slice of pecan pie. And then tell me about those cupcakes. They're so much fun.
Yes, ma'am. The cupcakes, we in Charlotte, we have a mobile bakery in Charlotte, which you can find on our website, www.bakinginc.com. Those are our cookies and cream cupcakes. It's a chocolate cupcake with a Oreo frosting. It's an Oreo buttercream on top of it.
And on top, and then a little tiny piece of chocolate chip or chocolate cookie on top.
It is.
To decorate.
It's a mini Oreo cookie on top of it.
So that, and that looks very, now many people are thinking about maybe baking and giving something they've made as a gift,
yes,
instead of going to the store and buying something. And I think that really shows love beyond, you know, that you've taken the time to prepare and bake something for someone. It shows a special love, I think.
It does. It takes patience, and you can also get your family in the kitchen and do things together.
Get your kids involved, even if it makes a mess.
Exactly.
Because that's what they remember.
Exactly.
When they're grown and gone, those are the things they remember. Not how much something cost when they open the gift. That's what they remember.
Exactly.
And tell me, Chef Lynard, you're in the Charlotte area.
Yes.
And how did you happen to become a chef? And you specialize in
desserts.
In desserts, don't you? Baked goods.
Yes, ma'am. My mom knew that I was cooking back in college, and I went home one day on college break and was asking for a red velvet cake.
Uh-oh.
Unfortunately, she told me, no, you know how to cook, and she gave me the recipe. Exactly. And
set you up in a career that you didn't know about.
That's pretty much what started my journey in baking.
I think that's beautiful. So you love doing what you do.
Exactly, I do.
And you have what in the Charlotte area?
Yes, we have a mobile bakery. It's a big purple food truck.
Okay.
That we named Sweetie.
Okay. And so if you're up in that area, you can look for it. And maybe you'll come down here sometime with that truck. We'd love to have you.
If we definitely get invites to different carnivals and things, we don't mind traveling.
And you bring on that truck what? Baked goods?
We have different baked goods from standard cupcakes, cookies, and brownies.
Oh, boy.
And we actually, the advantage that we have on it, we actually can bake on it.
Oh, my. Well, that, it sounds like an adventure.
It is.
We appreciate that you took the time and shared your talent with us. And if you would like the recipes that Chef Lynard shared with us today, please send a self-addressed stamped envelope to the Peggy Denny Show, Post Office Box 1616, Greenville, South Carolina, 29602. And the number of the recipe is 874. 874. And we'll do our best to get it in the mail to you so that you can share with your loved ones all the goodies when the time coming up that we have to share. Thank you for coming.
Bless you. Thanks for having me.
Thank you. Good luck.
All right. Thank you.
We'll see you next time. Bye-bye.